Well, hello, Internet, and welcome to part 5 of my Android development tutorial. If you haven't seen the previous parts of this tutorial, most definitely check those out. There's a link in the upper right-hand corner because I use a whole bunch of things that I talked about in parts 3 and 4 in this tutorial. And today what we're going to do is we are going to handle events that are going to be triggered by radio buttons, radio groups, checkboxes, drop-downs, and so forth and so on that we created in part 4 of the Android development tutorial. So I have a bunch to do, so let's get into it. Okay, so in the last part of the tutorial, we created the layout for our whole entire app here. And all the code is available in a link under the video in the description. Now what we need to do is set this up so that whenever any of these things are changed, we are going to change our tip up here, and then hence change the final bill amount. So there's a whole bunch of different events that we need to handle, and we're going to be handling them in crazytipcalc.java. And that is located over here in the source directory right here, crazytipcalc.java. So let's go over there and check it out. All right, so before I continue here, I wanted to cover update, tip, and final bill, which we created in part 3 of this tutorial, because we're going to be calling it a lot, and I just want to make sure you remember what it is. Basically, all it's going to do is it's going to get the tip amount, and it's going to get the tip amount by calling the editable text area called tip amount. We can jump over here, and this is what I'm talking about, this guy right here. And if we come over here, tip edit text, see, that's where that's coming from. And it's going to convert it into a double after it converts it into a string, which is what it does right here. And this is how you get a value from an editable text area. You go get text, and we're going to convert it into a double. And then we're going to come down to final bill, and we're going to calculate that by just taking the total bill times the tip amount and then adding that back to the total bill. And then if we want to set text to the final bill editable text area, which is this guy right here, all we're going to do is list the name for that editable text area, call set text on it, and then we're going to convert it into a string and format it so that it only has 2 digits in regards to decimal places and fills the rest of the area with zeros. And that is basically all we're going to do with that guy. I just wanted to review it real quickly. Then we can come down inside of here to where I made all the changes last time. And you can see here is the seek bar change listener. We're going to be creating a whole bunch more of those guys. And then if we come up inside of here, the very first thing I'm going to create is the setup intro checkboxes. So I'm going to copy that. And of course, in the last part, I went and initialized all the checkboxes so that we will be able to go in and both get values from them as well as set them. So let's just scroll down inside here and start creating all that stuff. And this looks like just about as good of a place as any to start. So I'm going to go private void setup intro checkboxes. And I'm just going to add change listeners to these guys so that I will be able to make changes to the tip amount anytime there are changes in the checkboxes. So we're going to have to come in here, and first thing I'm going to do is set up a change listener for the friendly checkbox. And to do that, you just go set on checked change listener. And then I'm going to go new, and there's a whole bunch of different ways to set up these change listeners. This is just one of them, and as the tutorial continues, I'll go over other different ways of doing it. Just wanted to give you something here that you'll be able to use right away. And then you just go change listener, and of course you don't have to memorize all this stuff. Just get the code and copy and paste it. And at the end of this, put a little curly brace, go like that, and then put a semicolon. We're going to do all this inline. And of course, make sure this is an uppercase O. And then it's going to say add unimplemented methods, and we're just going to copy that, and it's going to throw this in here. So now basically we have to decide what exactly we want to do when our checkbox is indeed checked. And what I'm going to do is, remember way back here, where is it? Right here, where I created check list values. This is going to just hold a whole bunch of values that are going to change depending upon checkboxes being clicked, or radio buttons being clicked, and all those other different things. And in a minute here, I'm going to show you exactly how we're going to be interacting with that to be able to calculate a new tip. So back down inside here again. All right, so here we got checklist values, and I'm just keeping this extremely simple. What I'm going to do is just say in the first array area, if the friendly checkbox is checked, and this is how you check if it's checked, well then the ternary operator is going to say for me, assign the value of 4 if it is checked, and otherwise assign the value of 0 to that array. And then what I'm going to do after that is now I have to calculate the tip using the waitress's new checklist options. And to do that, I'm going to go set tip from waitress checklist, and I'm going to create that in a second here. Actually, I'm going to copy it because I'm going to create it next. And then after that is set up, I'm going to go update tip and final bill, which is the very first thing I showed you at the beginning of this tutorial. So now after that, what I'm going to do is come down here and set up the tip from waitress checklist, this guy right here. So we're going to go private, void, set up from waitress checklist. That's a little bit of a mouthful. And then I'm going to go create an integer here. It's just going to be checklist total. It's going to be equal to 0. Then what I need to do is cycle through all the checklist items or checklist values. And then I'm going to take checklist total and just add all those values up inside of it. And there that is. And then after I have all those set, what I need to do is set the tip amount to the editable text area. And how you do that is go tip amount, editable text, set text. And I'm going to string format this again. And I'm going to say, all right, well, I want this to be, have two digits and fill up the rest of the space with zeros. And then I'm going to take checklist total. And on top of that, at the end of this, I'm going to multiply that times 0.01, which is going to give me a tip amount or a percentage. Okay, so now that I have that set up, I can come back up here and handle the rest of my checkboxes. So basically, if we scroll back up here again, we come to our checkbox area. Here we are. I have the friendly checkbox, the specials checkbox, and the opinion checkbox. This is pretty easy. Once I have one of these set up, the way I'm going to handle this is I'm just going to come in here inside of this and do this in line again. I'm just going to copy this, paste that in there. And then I'm going to call this specials checkbox. Don't have to change anything else. This is going to have to be set to 1. I'm going to change this to specials checkbox. And in this situation, if they tell me about the specials, I'm going to give them 1% more in their tip. And if they don't, I'm going to give them nothing. And everything else can be set up exactly the same way. And now to handle the opinions, being if the waiter or waitress gives me their opinions on what I pick, then here I'm just going to change this to opinion checkbox. And change this to opinion checkbox. Change this value here to 2. And then if they give me their opinion, I'm going to give them 2% more in tips. And if not, I'm not going to give them anything. And everything else can be exactly the same. So that is how extremely easy it is to handle events on checkboxes in Android. So now what we want to do is what I'm doing is looking here at these little red dots here. And that's how I'm deciding where I need to go to fix these method calls. And here is add change listener to radios. So I'm just going to copy that, scroll all the way back down here again, and I'm going to handle those events that are going to be called by those guys, those radio buttons, whenever they're clicked on. Void, add change listeners for radios. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to set all the listeners on the radio group and then handle them all here in a one situation or one little space here. So I'm going to go available radio group because the radio group surrounds all of the radio buttons. And we're just going to type in set on check change listener. And then we're going to go new on, make sure that's capital L, checked change listener. Close that off there. Put a curly brace inside of there. Closing curly brace right there. And a semicolon. And then this guy's going to say I need to add unimplemented methods. Do that for me. And there is the only unimplemented method, which is on checked change. And here I'm going to use the Java ternary operator again, just like I did before, just to keep this nice and simple. So I'm just going to come up here and copy this guy, come back down inside of here, paste it in, change that to 3. Actually, I'm going to do 3 of them because I have 3 radio buttons. So that's going to be 4 and that's going to be 5. And then these are going to change to available bad radio. And if they were a bad waitress, I'm going to subtract 1 from their tip. Going to copy this, paste that in there, paste that in there, and then if they were an okay waitress, put that there, and then here handle if they were a good waitress. Leave that set as 2 and 0, and then set this as 4 and 0. And then I have to do exactly the same things I did before. I need to update my tip, so I'm just going to copy this, and then update my tip and my final bill, and I'm just going to bounce down here, paste that in there, and save it. And that is how you are able to handle events for radio buttons inside of a radio group. So let's save that, and then we're going to scroll up here again to the next method we're going to have to handle. And this time we're going to handle the spinner or the drop-down box, so I have to create this guy. And here, of course, is where I initialized the spinner, which we talked about in the last part of the tutorial. So scroll way down here again, and once again I'm going to go private void, add item selected listener to my spinner. Going to do this in line again, problems, spinner. Here I'm going to go set on item selected listener, and then inside of here go new on item selected listener. See, looks the same again. Put a curly brace in there. Come down here, put a semicolon. Of course, it's going to say I need to add unimplemented methods. Just click on that. See, you don't have to memorize anything. And I set the code up so you could use it sort of like a cheat sheet anyway, so you wouldn't be able to use these things. And you can see here, on nothing selected, I'm actually going to ignore that altogether. And instead, I'm going to focus on item selected and change this guy right here. And then guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to use the ternary operator again. So I'm just going to copy all these, come down in here, paste that in there. And if they pick the first, second, or third option inside of my spinner or my drop-down box, I'm going to handle those. And to check which option was actually selected from those guys, we're not going to use is checked. We're instead going to use get selected item. And that's going to return to me whichever item they actually selected. And then after that, I'm going to go equals and see if it equals bad. And if the waitress was indeed bad, we're going to again give her a -1 on her tip, and otherwise it's going to be 0. And here, to make this a little bit more simple, I'm just going to copy that all together. Paste that in there, just like that. And then now I can just come in here and say, all right, did they provide okay? I can't even remember what it is. I think it was service or availability. If yes, it's going to be 3 in their tip. Otherwise, I'm going to set it to 0. And if they provided good service, I'm going to increase their tip by 6. And otherwise, this is going to be set to 0. And then what do I need to do? Well, I need to set up my tip properly for the waitress and then update my tip and my final bill just like I did before. So there that is. File save. And then that leaves me, if I bounce over here, so we got the checklist all set up. We have the radio button set up and the spinner. So now I have to make the chronometer actually work like a stopwatch, which requires a little bit of work. So we're going to come up here again, and there we are. So we're going to set our button, click listeners, and then whenever the buttons are clicked on, and when I mean buttons, I mean start, pause, and reset, they are going to change the chronometer. So I'm just going to copy that, scroll way to the bottom, and this time we're going to do something a little bit different. So if I want to add my click listeners for my buttons, I'm just going to go private void again. And here, set button on click listeners is just the name I gave it. And then I'm going to go start chronometer button set on click listener. Do this in line again. On click with a capital O, listener, right like that. Throw a curly brace in there, like that. Throw a semicolon at the end. And then, of course, it's going to say add unimplemented methods, no problem. There we go. Now I have to handle what exactly is going to happen when the start button is clicked on. So pretty simple. Well, the very first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create an integer here, and it is going to hold the total number of milliseconds that a pause lasts. So if they hit start and they hit pause, it's going to save that amount. I'm going to set this to 0 because start has been clicked, so we need to start storing milliseconds again for a future date, but it can be set back to 0 for now. And then if I want to get my string from my chronometer, just go string, and I'm going to go chrono text, time waiting, chronometer. And if I want to get the text that is inside of the chronometer, just go get text. And then I'm going to have to convert it into a string. And now that I have that string, I can go string array, convert it into an array by going chrono text and calling split on it. And it's going to come back with a colon between the different numbers for the chronometer. And just so you know what I mean, this is the chronometer, this thing down here, and it says 0.0. It's kind of little. You're going to see it in action here in a minute. And then what I need to do is take all these different parts in the array and figure out which ones stand for seconds and which one stands for minutes. So to do that, I can just go array length. If it's equal to 2, that means I'm going to be dealing with seconds going by instead of minutes going by. And if I want to calculate the number of seconds that have gone by, I'm going to assign stopped milliseconds and go integer parse int array, which is going to represent milliseconds. I'm going to multiply that times 60, math and stuff, and then just go plus. And then I'm going to go integer parse int again. We'll just come down here. And then this is going to be array 1, which is going to represent my seconds. Close that off and then multiply the whole thing times 1,000. So that's how I'm going to be able to figure out the seconds. And there we go. And then else, I'm just going to assume we're only going to be dealing with minutes here. Else if the array length is equal to 3, in that situation, I'm going to find the number of minutes. And I'm going to do sort of the same sort of thing, so I'm just going to copy this, paste that in there. And the stop milliseconds maybe wasn't the best of names, but either way, it works for this. And then here, I'm going to multiply this times 60, and then multiply it times 1,000 plus, jump down here, multiply times 60 times 1,000, and then finally add on integer parse array and then change this to 2 and then multiply that times 1,000. So that's just calculating minutes and seconds and all that stuff. So now that I know how many minutes and seconds that I have, what I'm going to need to do is calculate the amount of time that has elapsed since the start button was pressed minus the time that we were paused. And to do that, I'm just going to go time, waiting, chronometer, and I'm going to set the base, call system, clock, get the elapsed real time, and then subtract from that the number of milliseconds that I was paused after I hit start. So that's what that does. If that confuses you, this is, you know, the math stuff, so don't really worry about it. Just a cool added feature I wanted to put inside of here. And then after that, what I want to do is set the number of seconds that I have been waiting for a waitress to come to my table to fill my drink or do whatever. And I'm going to set this for seconds you wait. Obviously, in the real world, you wouldn't expect a waitress to be at your table in 10 seconds. But I'm setting it this way so that we won't have to sit and wait 10 minutes to see the results of waiting. So if you wanted to actually change this into something usable, you would use minutes instead of seconds, which would be array 2. And I'm actually going to save this above, so let's copy that, scroll way up here, down in here somewhere, seconds you waited. Oh, okay. I already did that in the last part of the tutorial, I forgot. So just change that to seconds you waited. And then after that, I'm going to go update tip based on time waited. And then inside of there, put seconds you waited. It's going to be minutes you waited. And then what I'm going to need to do is eventually create update tip based off of wait time. And then also, since we are still dealing, remember, this was all about what are we going to do when they click on the start button for the chronometer. So after we do all those different things, I need to actually start the chronometer so that it actually runs. And to do that, you just call start on it. So that's extremely simple. And then I'm going to create this guy, the update tip based off of time waited right now. And remember, it's going to get seconds you waited. So let's just copy the whole entire thing and then bounce down here. And I'm going to go private, void, update tip time waited on seconds you waited. And this is a long, remember. And then what I'm going to do is go checklist values and in the 9 spot, I believe that's what it is. Yes, checklist values, and there that is. And I'm going to do another ternary operator on this guy, so I'm just going to copy that. Scroll back down here, except this is going to be considerably less complicated. And here I'm just going to go seconds, you waited. And here I'm going to say if you waited more than 10 seconds, you're going to talk or tip. Again, don't get mad at me, I'm doing this just so it's quick. So if you wait less than or more than 10 seconds, she gets 2 taken off of her tip. And if you don't, she gets 2 added to her tip. And then what do I need to do? Well, I'm going to save that, and then I need to update the tip amount, and then I need to update the final bill. So I'm going to copy that again, come back down here again, and save it. And that leaves me with just figuring out what I'm going to do whenever the pause and the reset buttons are clicked. Pretty simple stuff. So here, actually, rather than I'm going to copy this, and that is going to be it, because I don't want to copy all this other stuff. So this time we're going to handle pause, what happens when the pause button is clicked on. Rest of this can all stay the same, like that, put in that, okay, so that's all set up. And then of course it's going to want my unimplemented methods, and there we are, and there that is, don't need all this space. And then it's going to be extremely simple to handle what we're going to do whenever the pause button is clicked on. All we're going to do is send a message, just like we did here, time waiting chronometer. Actually, just copy that whole entire thing. If we want to stop or pause the chronometer from ticking, we're just going to call stop on it. That was pretty easy. And then if we want to reset it, I'm just going to copy this whole entire thing, bounce that in there, and then call reset chronometer button. And I'm just going to go time waiting chronometer. And if I want to set it back to 0, I'm just going to go set base, system, clock, elapsed, real, time. And there we go. And then if I want to set my time counter as well for the number of seconds you were forced to be waiting for the waitress to 0, I'm going to do that. And that is it. All of our code has been done. So let's save everything. Jump over here. Make sure you save everything. And execute. And here is our tip calculator. And if I come in here and say change this to $12. And the tip here is set for 0. And of course, all that stuff still works, and you can see final bill change as it goes on the screen. But as soon as I would come in here and type in friendly, it's automatically going to change the tip amount. If they also talk about the specials, give their opinion, provide good availability, you can see that that is all going up. Here is our drop down if they were good at problem solving, 17%. And then you can also see here with the chronometer, if I hit start, it's going to start calculating the number of seconds that I need to wait. And remember, this is set for 19, that I set this for 10 seconds that I was willing to wait. Now watch 19 here, because I'm going to hit start right here and see how it dropped down by 4. Well, the reason why is they lost that part of their tip because it took them more than 10 seconds to get me my food or whatever. And then, of course, the pause works, as you can see. Start, again, works, and there it goes again. Pause, and then I can hit reset, and it goes to 0. So there are a whole bunch of different things you can do with Android. Hope you have fun with them. Please leave any questions or comments below. Otherwise, till next time.